Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. My name is Shrujna and today we are with Dr. Soumya, MD of Soumya Hospitals and also one of the leading gynecologists in this city. Let's welcome her. Hello ma'am, namaste.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm so good, thanks for asking. So doctor, how does diabetes affect pregnancy?
Diabetes in pregnancy is a major health issue. It's a medical condition which involves both the mother, the baby and after conditions of the mother and the baby. Diabetes is nowadays increasing. It is on rise. Previously it used to be only 3-5% of the woman, pregnant woman, but now it's on rise. It has increased from 3 to 7 to 10. In Hyderabad, almost 10% of women are having gestational diabetes. Gestational diabetes means they are having raised glucose levels during their pregnancy. It may be detected during pregnancy or it might have been already, she might have been diabetic earlier. So what we do when she comes for her first antenatal visit, that's the pregnancy visit, we do some basic screening tests whether she is having any glucose sugar tests. And in that sugar test, if she is having raised, random blood sugars are raised, then we advise her to get an HbA1c, a fasting blood sugar and a postprandial blood sugar, or sometimes commonly GCT, a test called glucose challenge test is done, which doesn't require any fasting. As she comes in the first visit, we give her a challenge of 100 grams of glucose or 50, depends upon the lab. So we give her 50 grams of Glucon-D. And after an hour, we check her blood glucose levels. If they are increased, they are more than 130 or 140, it is a test that her body is not tolerating so much of sugar. Her sugar levels are increased. Then we get her a HbA1c test, that is a glycosylated hemoglobin. In glycosylated hemoglobin, the hemoglobin, we test how much of sugar it is storing, the glucose storing in the hemoglobin. The lifespan of RBC is usually 120 days. So it's a three months her glucose control, how we can test how she is controlling her glucose. So if it is more than six, it is pre-diabetic. If it is more than 8, she is diabetic only. 5 to 6 pre-diabetic only, it is good control. 5 to 6 is good control, 6 to 7 and after 7 to 8 it is considered diabetic people. So by that we can identify people who are already diabetic, that is type 2 diabetes mellitus, and people and women who are just have become diabetic during the pregnancy due to her hormonal changes.
Yes, okay. So doctor, is diabetes normal during pregnancy? If yes, what are the causes and treatments for that?
Diabetes is not normal. It is a medical condition. It's a medical condition complicating the pregnancy. It is always a complication. Always the blood sugars have to be normal. If her sugars are increased, the first 3 months, if she is having raised blood sugar level, it may have problems in the baby also. The baby formation will be affected. The anomalies are there. Risks of anomalies are increased. Usually anomalies like the baby is big, her weight is big. She or he may get diabetes in his future. Fetal origin of adult disease, they say, because if her sugars are not controlled during the pregnancy time, the baby is more prone to get diabetes in their life, in future life. So the baby, other than that, anomalies of the spinal cord, neural cord defects are increased. So during the first 3 months when we get her in neural transferency scan, in that we see if the spinal cord is normal, if the baby formation is normal, if the HbA1c is more than 7 or 8, usually there is a risk of complications in the baby. And there are other complications in the mother also, because her diabetes is increased, she may be developing thyroid and BP in her second and third trimester, that is in 7th month or so. She may be at increased risk of getting raised blood sugar, blood pressure levels, her blood pressures may be increased. She may be at risk of getting fits, convulsions. So these are all there. So it is quite important to maintain her blood sugar levels, to the normal range.
Okay. But most of the people will be having this misconception of, you know, this diabetes is very normal during pregnancy. But since you have addressed that it has to be managed or treated, what are the causes and treatments for that?
Yeah, see, this is not a communicable disease. This is a non-communicable. The cause is in us.
Okay.
See, those who are genetically prone, like their mothers are having diabetes, they have developed diabetes, the mother side have developed diabetes in their pregnancies, she is more risk of having diabetes in her pregnancy.
Yes.
Or earlier pregnancy, if she is having GDM, she is more prone now to get GDM now.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the 10 to 20% of the people, as soon as they deliver, her hormone levels, due to the pregnancy hormone levels, they may get normal. As soon as she delivers, the glucose levels may become normal. But 50% of the women are more prone to get diabetes in future life.
Okay.
In future life, they are more prone.
Mm.
Half of them become diabetic soon. These women who have developed diabetes in this pregnancy are more prone to get diabetes in future, sooner than other people.
Mm-hmm.
Normal population, they are more prone because their hormonal imbalance is there.
Mm-hmm.
That's why.
Mm-hmm.
And another thing is that in these people with gestational diabetes, we have to identify the risk.
Mm-hmm.
Like they are obese, her BMI is increased. Mm-hmm. It is more than 26 or 28 or morbid obese, 28, 35, okay, like that. These people are more prone.
Mm-hmm.
Who are already hypertensive and hypothyroid. Mm-hmm. Hypothyroid women are also more prone to get diabetes.
Okay.
So we have to consider them. And again, in women who are obese, in this pregnancy, we have to advise them that they should not, other than the diabetic diet they are taking, we have to keep a control on their calorie intake, and we have to advise them that she should not gain more weight. It depends how much weight you have to gain. See, women who are having a normal BMI, usually underweight women don't get diabetes that we can take off. Other than type 1 diabetes, other than type 1 diabetes people who are diabetic, who are having gestational diabetes in this pregnancy, women who are having a BMI of normal range, below 25, these people can gain almost 7 to 11 kgs as normal women. There is no problem.
Right.
The problem comes when the women are already obese. They are overweight and obese, 25 to 28 and 28 above. It decreases. We cannot allow them to gain more weight. Like we can tell, in the whole pregnancy, you can only gain 7 kgs.
Okay.
Not more than that. We have to advise. If they are suddenly in the next visit, they are coming and they have gained 2 kgs or 3 kgs in a month. We have to say, this is not going well. You have to have a limit of threshold to maintain. Like you can gain half a kg a month or so, or a kg a month. In after 7 months, the weight gain increases because the fetus demands are increasing. So the later months it's okay, but earlier months we can, before 7 months we can tell her to have a threshold, don't gain more than half a kg, it's better. And we have to also advise her to take a nutritious diet. Other than the protein diet we give, we have to advise her to take a fruit for the multivitamins, daily one fruit, not the fruits which have having high glycemic index, like which are very sweet, like chiku and something like that. And apple also, it depends upon the size and portion of it also. But we have to advise them to take at least a fruit a day, 2 glasses of milk a day. And when it comes to milk, the main question which comes is, can we add artificial sweetness or we should add sugar? There is a bias on all this also. Artificial sweeteners are nowadays not very encouraged. Natural sugar only, that is also plant-based, they can take, but in a limited quantity. According to her glucose control, if her glucose control is better, she can take normal quantity, not too sweet. But if sugars are not under control, she is not advised to take sugars at all.
Okay.
In the milk.
Yes.
And we advise protein powder, 30 grams daily, because the baby, for the development of the baby, she needs protein. So she should regularly take protein. Carbohydrates also she should take, but in limit. Okay. And fats, a little bit of fats is okay, not too much. of that. It depends upon her weight gain and her glucose control. Sugars, when we talk about sugars, juices are not encouraged in diabetic women because it gives a sudden rise in the blood glucose level. So she is advised to take the fruit as a whole because of the fiber content. Mm-hmm. Fiber content is also important. Right. For her bowel movements, fiber is important. So we advise her to take fruits daily. And when it comes to diet, normally we advise her 3 meals and 3 snacks a day. Mm-hmm. And the meal portion should not be more than the snack.
Okay.
So the meal portion and the snack portion are almost same. So she should take little meals, not a big portion of meal, and again taking a big portion of snacks.
Okay. Can she have 3 meals per day or 5 to 6 meals per day?
It's not that. Meal, when I say I'm talking about a meal, is rice and chapati and so.
The main course.
Yeah, main courses. So the main courses quantity should be less.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And this which we are decreasing the portion, main meal, we are adding through the snacks.
Okay.
So after 2 or 3 hours, she can have a fruit or she can have some egg, boiled egg, or she can have some badam soaked, or she can have some walnuts. Like that,
so
she can
regularly she can have in a day, per day calories.
It is 3 meals and 3 snacks.
Right.
This is which has become normal now.
Mm-hmm.
We advise her 3 meals and 3 snacks, but we tell we should not take meals, big meals.
Okay.
In a big snack.
In a large amount.
Yeah, yes. We should not advise them to take big snacks. If you are taking 3 big snacks and 3 big meals, it doesn't help you in any ways. It will increase your blood sugar levels more.
So, doctor, pregnant ladies already undergoes with so many medications and drugs. So beside that, in order to control diabetes, do you also suggest diabetic medications?
See, when the woman comes to us and first time she is encountering that her blood sugars is increased, first what we say is for 15 days, we give her time to control her diet, nutritional therapy. Take nutritious food, but decrease the food which are having high glycemic control, like rice. She can switch to brown rice, properly soaked and properly boiled, and good fiber food.
Yes.
Then after 15 days, if her blood sugars are less than 200, then not women who are having 400 or so, in between. So after 15 days, if she is able to maintain her glucose levels, then it's well and good. We advise nutritional therapy only.
Okay.
Right. And women who are not having a good control, we advise them. Nowadays, oral drugs are also encouraged. Who have not a bit problem in their glucose tolerance, glucose control, insulin sensitizers are given. But when her blood glucose levels are not under control, we usually advise them to take insulin. What we see, what is the difference between normal people with type 2 diabetes and GDM? Their insulin requirement is not much. It is very little, 5 to 10 only. So nowadays, nice pen insulins have come. So they are not so painful. With having the fear of having an insulin injection, if they don't control their sugar, she'll end up in complications. So nowadays, insulin pens have come which are painless. They have the needles are very fine, so you don't even have so much of pain. Earlier, they used to give subcutaneous injections. These are also subcutaneous, but the needle is fine. So she, most of them are comfortable. We are advising pen injection. Usually we send them to endocrinologist or a physician.
Okay.
So they'll take up the challenge of controlling their diabetes.
Right. Okay. So thank you so much for doctor for giving us the informative details about many important topics.
Thank you. Thank you, Srijana.
Yes, ma'am. So viewers, please like, share and comment. You can always drop the question which you wanted to ask in the comment section, and thank you so much for watching.